welcome you all to the June 5th Select Board meeting. First order of business, I would suggest a call to order, the approval of the May 22nd meeting. Is that the meeting you were here for?
That's, yes.
That's the last one, okay.
Yes.
You're good with them, or?
It was only us.
Right.
Yeah.
I was thinking, it's one before that fell off, we need to make sure we put that back on. Caroline, the meeting before that?
It's still, should still be on.
When Jody wasn't able to make it?
Okay.
Then, when the minutes were ready for approval, Suzanne wasn't here.
Okay.
5:15, thank you. Community input? Any community input yet this evening?
Not yet.
All right, we'll continue on then. Department head business, the building inspector was not here this evening, but he has been monitoring activity on Church/Washington Street property, 79 Rollins Road.
Is in your folder.
Perfect, you wanna?
There are four in your folder.
Do you wanna do them all now?
We'll do it with the one, just open order and we'll bang them out as we go along here. 79 Rollins Road, I don't know the issue, but so.
Paving.
Paving.
79 is paving, there's some line.
79, okay, okay, thank you. Ian Norberg, 79 Rollins Road, dear Mr. Norberg, the Select Board has been apprised of the following activity at 79 Rollins Road. Paving, it's likely that the above activity requires a building permit and the rest of the boilerplate, right? Please contact Caroline Lamro, phone number or email, in order to review relevant building requirements and start the permitting process if necessary. The consistent application of town regulations, particularly with regard to the property values, provides for the equitable distribution of taxation to all property owners, is in the Select Board's express wish to be fair, equitable and consistent in such matters, thank you for your cooperation, but Ms. Snyder?
So moved.
All right.
Caroline.
That's going to Mr. Norberg.
We have another one.
Oh, hold on, okay. The next item we're tabling, that's the minimum housing standards ordinance, Suzanne wanted to ask if we would wait till we return, I'm okay with that, health inspector. I don't see him here this evening either, but it is of note that his commission expired at the end of the month, or expired.
It will expire on the 18th.
On June 18th, so we have reached out to him to see if he's interested in remaining on as the health inspector. Fire department, they are not here yet, so pass over them. Highway department, we have a non-public personnel, we wanna hold off on that then, do we get to the other stuff, or you wanna do it now?
Sure. Well, they're not here. Everything else I need Jeff for.
He's not here tonight, he's not able to come tonight.
Okay.
So we can take other stuff on here, I didn't know if we needed him here for that part.
For the gazebo, I.
No, no, the non-public part. Do we need him here for that, or? We can hold it till the end of the evening then?
Yeah, they can hold it till the end of the evening.
Okay, so we don't have to make people get up then?
Yes.
They don't need to. Okay, so the parking on Foundry Street, I think there's a letter regarding that in there.
Yes, there is.
Apparently, we've talked about this in the past, I guess, I'll read the letter, it'll be easier to read the letter. And decide whether or not we like it or not. All right. Mr. Ernest Osborne and Ms. Marna Grushek. I apologize, I probably butchered your name, I'm sorry. By now you have no doubt noticed that Foundry Street has been repaved. Part of that project includes the installation of swales on the side of the road in front of your home. The swale is a paved U-shaped path that directs stormwater into the catch basins. The swales are a rather fragile structure, they are part of the handwork involved after the road has been machine paved. This handwork does not have the same support structure as the road and will crumble if repeatedly driven over. Therefore, we have to ask that you not drive over the swale. If damaged, the town will have no other option than to bill you for repairs if you continue to drive over it. Vehicular travel is limited to roadways and driveways. It has been noted that there are tire tracks in the new loam spread in that area indicating that the swale has been driven over. Enclosed is a copy of RSA 236:13, the state law regulating driveways. Please see paragraph 6 as it applies to the situation. If you require an additional driveway or need to widen your existing driveway, that is a process that you may proceed with through the planning department at your own expense. Regret any inconvenience has caused you and hope you can understand our need to protect this public access, and then I would need to sign it. And we have attached the pertinent chapter of RSA 236.13. Hopefully, paragraph we referenced. It's there, entitled 6. What do you think about that?
Well, I drove by today,
yeah.
And he has always parked his boat there.
Okay.
So, I don't know why there wasn't a new cut-in or an old cut-in, or he's been using that spot for his boat.
Okay.
So, I don't know if it becomes grandfathered at this point, because the boat was there before, in and out, before you paved this road. So that has always been there.
So when we put the swale, I guess what the part of the problem is when we put the swale on, if people drive over it, side across, I guess it crosses
right.
it. So
right.
we need to decide
so
whether or not we want to protect that.
We put, for other spots, like I gave an example this morning on my road, they're actually Dover residents, but they started using a side entrance, and when they repaved that bottom part of the road, they put in a cut-in for that slot, even though it wasn't there before.
So we need to, okay. Doesn't seem to be consensus then on sending this letter then, at least, well, the way it's written. So we will hold off on that then. Next item is manager at the transfer station. Is that you?
That is me.
Okay.
So, transpiring actions this week, I went down in uniform issues and all that. Got advice from other towns and what they do and what they wear.
I'm sorry.
That's
I'm not
okay.
making faces at you.
No, no, no.
That's
fine.
My
we are dealing with allergies. I understand.
Yeah, sorry.
So, I was thinking that maybe we should look into a transfer station manager, where Jeff is so busy doing all these other projects,
mm-hmm.
that let them manage themselves. Obviously, we can't make that decision tonight, but it's
okay.
worth starting the conversation.
So we want to keep that, we'll table that for now then, but we'll
yes.
keep, so we keep the conversation going?
Yes.
Bicentennial Park Gazebo, I believe, is also you.
Yes, that the rec committee wanted the older kids to do a community cleanup kind of thing,
mm-hmm.
but the gazebo has 6 seats, well,
yeah.
it used to have 6, it has 5,
yes.
and nails now.
Yes.
So I was going to have Jeff pick up the part that has nails. And then the kids are going to go clean that up when they start summer camp.
Are we talking about that under rec too, or? It didn't, part of the question was whether or not we wanted to permit that, right? The work to be done by the kids? Isn't that on here somewhere? Was that request to paint?
No, they wanted
plant
to do
flowers
something
paint.
Over at, over by the Legion. I think that was another project they wanted
oh,
to do.
Okay. Was
Kathy
about.
Has them all over town.
That was Kathy was like, wasn't that the that wasn't the gazebo in Bicentennial Park?
I thought it was because the other gazebo doesn't belong to the town.
Yeah, the other one is.
I think that's where
she
went.
I think she wanted to do both originally.
I'm fine with them planting flowers and
yeah.
and
cleaning
up.
Yeah, I just
the
wanted
gazebo.
Jeff to clean up the nails before the kids got
yeah.
there.
Yeah, I think she wanted them to scrub off like graffiti and paint
mm-hmm.
it. Yeah, I'm fine with it.
Yeah,
I'm good with it.
And we'll just have Jeff pull up the nails before summer camp starts.
That'd be good.
So, are you fine with me just sending him an email?
You
want
to just make a motion that we do a formal.
Do we? Okay, make a motion to allow the summer rec children to do volunteer work at Bicentennial Park this summer. Dates pending.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. So it's for community service that they. As part of
it's
summer rec thing, was part of with performance community service back. So that's great. I think it's terrific.
Yeah.
So I just want to make sure we have a formal agreement to that, if anyone asked. Concrete patch quote. I don't see the man with the quote, so I think we might table that.
Yes.
I don't, unless there's something, there's nothing in the. Okay. We just did the paint and plant flowers too, right? I'm assuming we're doing that. That was awesome. Okay. And parking on Foundry, I'm just going to say table for now because we need to obviously need to figure out what we're going to do about that. It's fine that this isn't the solution, but we gotta figure something out for the resident and for us, I think, so. Gotta be a happy medium, I hope. Truck on South Street is gone, so yay. We can cross that one off our list. We thank the police department for taking care of it again. Main Street parking, is that you? Not me.
Yeah, well, when we were talking, I went over the agenda today. Why are we penalizing people on South Street if they're parking up front when they're doing it on Main Street?
Are you asking me why that happened?
Yes.
Because South Street is,
So the ordinance doesn't apply to Main?
It's the way that the ordinance is written, it's specific to specific streets, and specific portions of specific streets, it's not like it's all encompassing.
I think, so that doesn't include them?
That portion, yeah, it's my understanding. I'm not saying I like that, I'm just saying that's.
Okay, so I always thought that.
Yeah, I didn't do it, so.
No, I thought you didn't like them parking there because of the ordinance. But.
No, I don't, I just think it looks.
Okay.
I just don't think it looks very nice having people park them, and plus it's a.
But they are allowed.
You're asking me if they're allowed to? There isn't, there, in the ordinance, it does not specifically say that they're not allowed to park there.
Okay.
Is my understanding. Now, I don't think that's equitable.
Okay.
I don't think it looks very nice either, that people are parked in their front lawns, it's not really their lawn, it's the town's right of way. Some of them park on the sidewalk. There was an effort in the 70s, I think Ed told us, or told, I'll say Alice, but you weren't there, obviously. To plant trees
mm-hmm.
in that spot, and then residents that lived there were very upset with around their parking space in front of their house. And so the select board at that time said just abandoned the idea. And I don't think they got busy and didn't bring it up again.
Okay.
So if you want to look into doing it, Aaron, you should do it. I mean.
No, I didn't want to be picking on one resident and not another when I wanted to make sure.
They changed on Cross Street. Part of Cross Street you couldn't park, and so then last year, we did it the entire street, we couldn't
right.
park on the street. We changed a year
yeah,
and a half, 2 years ago, South Street, and then reversed part of that decision for the people in
right.
summertime.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember all the details,
yeah.
But I don't think, we haven't changed any other streets, have we, in the last at least 4 years.
There's the area in front of the upper mill where the parking lines had to change when they repaved it and they moved the center line so that there wasn't room for parking up there.
Yeah, and the chief wanted it not there and then in extending more on the other side of the street, right?
That's it, yeah.
That was last year.
Yeah. That's it, that's been existing policy. But it is worth noting that if you go to the house right here, right? The new house, it's not new, really. Newly refurbished house to our left, there's a sign up front that says they can't park there. So the ordinance must start there, and it goes all the way down to the end of Main Street, to the intersection of Front Street. So, although I will say that I see cars every night parked in front of the store. So, the little store right next door.
Mm-hmm.
They just park there running in, even though it's illegal. So, we can ask the police department if they show up tonight. So. You want to keep it on or move
no.
across from? Okay, that's what I know about Main Street parking. It's like a test tonight. Pick my brain. Town administration.
Can we catch up?
What? Oh, I'm sorry. Welfare's not on my agenda.
It's not.
No,
I
don't.
Have any,
stick to
I
the
do.
Script. You have a welfare case for us tonight? Okay,
but
then.
Move into non-public for repair and welfare.
Second. We'll do a roll call. Jody?
Yes.
Mike, yes, it's unanimous. We're in non-public session for welfare. We're all slow walking in. Actually, it did just change to 6:59. 6:58 and 3 in 9:10.
I'm going to put 6:58.
Perfect. Okay, so for case number 2017-002. The board is recommending up to $500 in rental assistance.
Second. So moved.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Have a good night.
Thanks.
Okie dokie, now on to town administration, we're moving right along then. Town hall roof is an addition. Added for, forget about it, we wanna talk about the cupola.
Yep, yes, I'm like, oh, I don't think I need to know that. Yeah, so the email, you saw the email, the cupola was in bad shape.
It's out.
Yes, now it's out in the hallway. They could repair it for about $2,000. I happened to be speaking with somebody from CNJ when I got the call. They can repair it for about $2,000. They would put a black coat on it, so like an undercarriage coat that they would normally do on their equipment. Problem is, we don't have the funds to fix it right now. So I was hoping that, you know, we can't put it back up because it would have been a safety hazard. Good, because it's about 40 miles an hour, sometimes higher, wind gusts up there. This piece we're finding, Kate found pictures, or Peter found pictures that gave to Kate, and it used to be like, kind of like a lightning rod kind of thing on the top. So I was thinking the historical committee could, like, since it's in there, in, now people can see it and touch it, and, you know, hey, that used to be up top, and raise funds for that, and then when we fix it, have a ceremony and bring it back up.
Get the proper finial back on top of the tomb. Okay, Mark Kucher, who's a welder, also was saying that there are, he knows folks that specialize in that kind of work, and he'd be happy to reach out to them.
Oh, that would be wonderful. Oh, and did you want to...
He thought it was in the right wheelhouse that caught that amount of money, so...
Okay. And did you want to hear how the roofing was done prior to our last roofing company?
Sure, why not?
So they put the...
Is it gonna make me angry?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So they put the shingles to that piece of metal, to the cupola.
To the end cap there?
Yes, to the end cap. And they did not take the end cap off and bring the shingles all the way up. So it's been exposed to just wood. And that circle that used to hold a lightning rod has just been filling up with water.
Yeah.
So I don't, we've paid all these engineering costs to see where the water's been coming from. And that might be one.
I'm sure that's probably a pretty good source, the giant hole on the top of the roof.
So now it has, it's nice and tight and secure. And...
Yeah, no, after that it's done. So I'll just let it go at that. So we're gonna get this onto the standing agenda and we'll add it under, eventually, we'll put it under historical committee. So we have a chat with those folks next time we meet.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. But the roof does look good. I'm glad they finally were able to finish. Weather wasn't terribly cooperative, was it?
No, oh, and...
I'm guessing they spent a lot more on crane rental.
No, I asked, because I was afraid of that. I said, how much more is it gonna cost us in crane rental? He goes, you're only paying up till Friday, you're only gonna be charged an extra day. So he was estimating it was gonna take 2 weeks.
Oh.
I didn't know that, I thought it was gonna take a week.
Yeah, me too.
So he had budgeted in that.
So
we are gonna get a little bit of an overage, but not as bad as we thought.
Alrighty, so, okay. Next thing we have is Stratford Regional Planning Commission meeting date in July. They want to come talk to us about rising tides. Amongst other things. I'm trying to find email Kyle sent. Basically, they want a date in July. Every day looks open except for July 3rd for me.
Me too. I don't have any vacation or anything then.
Say that again?
I don't have any vacations or anything.
So every other day in July works?
Mm-hmm.
So let's just pick one then.
Mm-hmm.
We were saying we could just come in at 6.
Yeah.
He wants to do like a 20-minute presentation.
Yeah.
On it's the Coastal Advisory Committee on their report. 17th is fine by me. So we'll book it now.
That'll have to be noticed, right?
Pardon?
And that'll have to be noticed.
Yeah, oh yeah, we'll make sure it gets...
have a selectmen's meeting on the
3rd? I don't know, to be honest with you. I'm not gonna be here, so you all can do whatever you want. I'm gonna pull Suzanne and be away.
Can you make sure we put that on the agenda for next week?
Yeah, right. Now I am.
If we're working July 3rd?
I'm gonna, let me just finish this so I don't forget it.
That'd be a Monday.
I know, that's what I'm asking.
All right.
Yeah.
Just.
Yeah, I don't know. I would assume we probably are, but. Unless there are gonna be enough people here, I guess.
Big weekend.
Yeah? It is actually. Holiday weekend, when is that? Sorry, I'll hold everybody up. Okay. I'll make sure they get added on, so. July 17th. All right, next thing, dog waste downtown. The village vet is going to order a few signs. He's gonna let me know if it's gonna be two or three, and we can decide on where they're gonna be located, where we wanna locate them. He's paying for them, which is very nice.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. Projects, covert projects, easements, legal review. There's a letter in there that we need to,
I'm sure we can.
So this is the right-of-way certificate. There's two copies for us to sign. The undersigned hereby certifies, except as noted in the report below, that the undersigned has acquired and presently holds continuous and adequate rights of way on private lands needed for the construction, operation and maintenance of the facilities to be installed, repaired, or enlarged with the proceeds of a loan made or insured by and/or a grant from, cover all bases, United States Department of Agriculture, and such omissions, defects, or restrictions as may exist will in no substantial way or manner endanger the value of the operation of the facilities. If we are good, we should sign it. So we're good. Oh, I guess it just means that, so I'm good. I like it. Oh, that's like. Ah.
I saw that.
All right.
And that same note?
Yes.
In correspondence, we got a letter from the attorney that we are good for our $380,000 bond, and it's a little ticky as well.
Okay.
$300,000 general obligation bond to be sold to the town of Rollinsford, New Hampshire, to the USDA rural development dated, and didn't put a date on it.
That's from Divine Norman, the bond council?
Yes.
All right, so.
That's in correspondence to go along with that.
I want copying and scanning. Do you wanna take that soon? Do you wanna wait till Suzanne gets back?
I talked to Caroline today, and I talked to them, and we're just putting it on hold till these bigger projects come in, so we know we have the money.
So, I've already lost my page, all right, table that. Avatar, where do we begin? Okay.
Do you wanna start with that conversation?
I didn't add it on, but I don't know if Caroline just added it on. You can go ahead and start. I have lots to say about them as well.
Okay.
But you go ahead.
Okay, so.
I think you're probably saying similar things.
Yeah, so I was approached by Andrea. I'm assuming you were approached by Andrea, because we can't talk together during the week. Andrea found multiple mistakes that Chad has made, or.
Avatar.
Avatar.
Right.
There was over 100 building permits. Not all of them were put into this, this tax go-around. Even the four houses on Wentworth Street were not even put on. She found that as an error too, and the more she dug, the more error she found. She's hasn't finished it. So I think the select board needs to bring them in, and we have a contract with them, and we're in the middle of a,
yeah,
of a assessment. So some of our residents are going to get slammed with giant bills in the summer. We have barns that aren't even assessed right now. The whole barn. So I think we need to bring him in and...
Yeah, no, I think we should have come and have a conversation with us for sure. I mean, it's, first of all, I think we need to thank Andrea for,
yes,
for catching, I don't just call them mistakes, the most,
yes,
errors on Avatar's part. It's very troubling to me that this company would make these mistakes. They seem to be taking corrective action, so I'm told, not 100% yet, but yeah, I want to make sure the assessments are correct, the reevaluation is correct.
Because
I don't want to have, I don't think any of us want to have to pay any more than we actually owe, because
right,
someone else isn't paying their fair share because they're not assessed properly. It's not fair to anyone, so for sure. So yeah, we should we'll apprise Suzanne of a situation if she hasn't already seen the litany of emails while she's on vacation, but she does check them sometimes. See how we want to proceed when she gets back. But I think for the very least we'd have to come in and have a conversation with us.
Right.
We'll see where we go from there. But not just that, not only did they screw that up, is it on here? Did it not make it on here? So they screwed that up, and there's also been some errors apparently with some of the paperwork for folks that were applying for elderly and veterans exemptions.
Yes, I was here manning calls
yes,
this morning.
Thank you for that,
yeah.
Which I also find very troubling. So, you know, some people don't actually qualify and they were getting it for a number of years. We have caught a few of those. That I don't feel is bad, but if you don't qualify, you don't qualify. But if it's because there was an error made on our assessing company's part, I want to make sure it gets solved quickly. So yeah, it's a twofer. They didn't add in all the building permits, so some properties aren't properly assessed, and some people aren't getting. Some people may be getting exemptions that they don't deserve, and some people that deserve them may not be getting them.
Correct.
So, yes, we need to fix that, and we're going to. So, that is that. About Avatar, I think we'll probably just stop there for now. I don't have anything else to say about them, but I think that's... quarterly department head meetings. So, in the past, Suzanne used to hold, I think she may still, I don't know if she does, used to hold quarterly department head meetings.
Correct.
And I think you got a question about it. Or you want to say a time back or something?
When I was here today, I thought that that would be a good idea. I know she has a lot on her plate, and if that's something that I can help with,
I think
she
still does it. So I don't know. Maybe it just sort of fell off in the last couple of last quarters. I thought she was still doing it. Maybe she's not. So
I don't know, but if the transfer station is going to have their own. One of the other things that I found when I was doing bills was, you know, like Jeff went and bought like supplies for cleaning. Well, he bought a soap, a roll of toilet paper. Why are we not buying in bulk? And why isn't one person doing it? He took 2 days, 2 hours out of your schedule to go get supplies at Home Depot when you have a credit card. Why didn't, first off, why don't you go to Walmart for a better price?
So we can...
Because it was on the credit card, that's how I caught it.
Right. So the quarterly department had meetings to help coordinate that for sure.
Correct.
I mean,
so
it could fall on one person to do the ordering. Or maybe if they rotate on whatever they want to come up with. But really, that's the department has something I would think to figure that out. They should be able to figure that out. New Hope housing tax exemption. They, as far as I know, they did not receive it this year. They had not turned in all of their paperwork, apparently. One thing that Avatar did catch. Sorry, this should be nicer. So we're happy that happened, but I'm sure they'll be appealing. I mean, imagine they would probably appeal, so we may be hearing from them. But the tax bill went out, and it went out, and they got a bill. They did not get an exemption. So. ADA coordinator, coordinator. So, last we spoke about this, we did not believe we had that many employees, but lo and behold, we add up all of the on-call firefighters that I don't think of as sort of traditional town employees, but they are in fact. We do meet the criteria, so. There were, seemed to be two logical, three logical people. The first would be Tom Clark, because he's our building inspector. You'll probably be the most familiar with it. Then maybe the health officer,
mm-hmm.
or Caroline, because she's here,
yeah.
centrally located. So I would think we'd want to ask Tom first. It shouldn't add much to his plate, but apparently we have to have one person designated.
Correct.
So do we want to... Do
you want me to send an email to Tom and
see
ask
if
him?
He'd be willing to
okay.
do it? Or just, yeah. Okay. I'm fine with that as well. The next is, I can't wait to get this crossed off and never have to deal with, well, not have to deal with it again anytime soon, I don't think. Is the Oak Street boundary. We have talked about in the past, well, we've talked about a lot in the past, but the last month and a half, 2 months, we did get the survey. Thank you. The survey back from Mr. McElhaney out of Dover, and I think we've talked about it here before in the meeting. But lo and behold, if we haven't, we'll talk about it now. The town line, the city line, I know it's going to come as a shock to everyone involved. Is down the middle of Oak Street. I know. Let the people rejoice. So, it's only taken 40 years or so, a little longer than to figure this out, but we've got it. And I think that at least the Rollinsford Select Board, we haven't officially said it yet, but I think we're comfortable with that notion. The City of Dover is going to address it at a workshop Wednesday evening.
This Wednesday.
Should
we be there?
No, no, it's, the city council is just doing their thing.
Okay.
And then if they want to, they will formally bring it to the full council. I think it was the 15th or whatever their next regularly scheduled council meeting is. And then they will reach out to us and we will preambulate. We will walk the line like we're supposed to by statute. I'm not walking down the middle of Oak Street, but we're supposed to do a perambulation every so often, so as prescribed by statute, so we will. I don't know if we're prepared. Do we want to just wait till Suzanne comes back to take the formal vote? Because I mean, Dover's not going to act on it before that, but I just want people to know. That way, I believe we are very close to finally solving one issue that we had inherited. So I'm happy about that. I'm happy that it's taken as long and the expense that we had to go to, but the old quote unquote gentleman's agreement of it was down the center line and they were just, it was actually true. So we can actually get this in an MOA actually. And
when we do get it, maybe we should put it up in the behind the four quarters so we don't lose it again.
Right. Well, I don't think we ever lost it. We never have. So.
Well.
Anyway, so that's exciting, I think, personally. So we're going to table that until Suzanne gets back, but I thought at least we should talk about it. Rec committee. Is there anything else to talk about with the rec committee?
Yes, unfortunately,
okay.
There's lots because right. They're about to start.
Okay.
So, right now we have 61 kids. We expect a few
Great.
More because last minute registrations.
Yeah.
We have four full-timers above the age of 18, one director above the age of 18, and one part-timer above the age
mm-hmm.
of 18. So we need probably three, four more counselors
okay.
to make sure the numbers are right.
Now, you wanted 100 kids? Is that what you were hoping for?
About, you budgeted it for about 100.
And it's 61
115
now.
Was what the budget was based on. However, we break even at 80.
So, so the select board had said we need 51% above the 51% 18 and older, 49% of counselors 16 and 17 year olds.
Okay.
We have three people that are potential hires, and they're 17 and a half.
Okay.
So, would it behoove the board to go to 49% 18 and plus, and 51% 16 and 17 year olds? So, for background, since you weren't at the meeting, it was my idea, because working with Andrew, who's our new director, he is into safety. He is right on top of things.
Well, I mean, I guess I could say that there are...
And it was a unanimous vote at the rec committee.
I'm sure
to ask the select board to change their mind.
More competent and more responsible 17-year-olds than there are 18-year-olds, I'm sure, in the world, so... The, and it was unanimous, you said, so you were supporting it too then? You're comfortable with it?
So moved?
I'll second it then.
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Of,
Let's
reiterate what we're
doing. The summer rec staffing will consist of at least 49% of counselors 18 and older,
mm-hmm.
and 51% that are 16 or 17 years old.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? All right.
Wait,
no, no, I just corrected that one.
Okay.
So keep going. I know you got more. So
they're come to find out they're going to be paving at the school during the summer as well. So now,
okay.
I asked Kate today, and it's on the 10th, I believe. I forwarded it to you just so
yeah.
as an FYI.
Yeah.
School's paving. Mm-hmm.
So they're paving the basketball court area.
Right. Right.
So
that's because
I didn't
money.
Know about it, but
okay.
apparently, so we found out, or I found out, yes.
Where, I'm sorry, what day is it again they're doing it?
They think July 10th.
Okay, and when does the program start?
Oh, it's going to be in the middle of the program.
Okay.
Yeah. So we also have the culvert work in the back.
Right.
And they're building a shed.
Yes.
And I thought the shed was going to be done during April vacation,
yeah,
but that's
not
up yet.
I bring a lot, so.
So I don't know when the shed is.
Okay.
So the other question that they had last night was the extended school program, which are the kids that do the summer reading program on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesdays.
Okay.
Some of them are going to be campers.
Okay.
So the school bus drops them off.
Okay.
For the summer reading program.
Where?
At the
school.
School.
Okay.
Who signs them in and who signs them out?
I don't know.
So we were like, oh, good question.
So
the school bus drops them off for the reading program. Is the teacher that does the reading program going to then sign them in to a camp? Or is a counselor going to sign them in? The camp director would have to do it to sign them in.
Yeah.
Andrew has dealt with this in the past. He said that in Rochester.
And what did they do in Rochester?
They had swim lessons, and the swim instructor signed them in and out.
Counselor signed them out and swim instructor signed them back in because the counselor couldn't leave their other attendees in the camp.
Correct.
So
and
they would walk the kids in their class down to the swim class, sign them into swim class, and then it was the swim instructor who signed them back into the camp when the instructor was done with their lesson.
So I was thinking... I probably
don't want to recreate the wheel then.
Right.
In Rochester, it might work in Rollinsford.
Right. So we were just getting a letter from the parent saying, yes, my Dr. So-and-so is doing the reading with the child, may sign my child into summer camp after a reading program. So
seems to be
the easiest way to go.
Easiest way to go, as long as there's a letter of approval from parents. And often from parents, I would think that would be the best thing.
Right.
So I mean, if that's what the rec committee thinks will work best for them.
So,
that's an easier one.
So
what about the paving the basketball courts? Did we ever figure out? Is this an FYI?
This is an FYI for now. Apparently, the email said that she had talked to other people in the rec committee, and they had already known, but when we were meeting last night, no one was really sure.
So when do you go on your field trips? What day? Can they do it that day?
Tuesdays and Fridays are field trip days, but it's going to take more than one day, most likely, if they're going to, depending on what they're doing.
Is this an overlay, or is it? We don't
I don't know.
Okay. Well,
that's a school board meeting issue, and none of us can go to the school board meeting, so.
When?
Thursday.
This Thursday?
Yeah, and it was quite funny to listen to all of us go around the room, and everybody was at a baseball game on Thursday.
Let me see.
I tell you.
Wrong week. If I got in the right week, I can look. Sorry, I.
And I'm not gonna be there.
But busy week this week, yeah, I'm sorry, I can't go to the school board.
See?
All right, well, maybe we could, you can send, you sent an email to the principal, I think I saw, right?
I did send in the principal, sent her a letter, they.
Yeah.
They assume around the 10th, and they have other exits for us to use, so.
Okay, so those is, that one week, you'll have to do other activities, I guess, so you can best, basketball courts, or?
Yeah, it, not using it isn't the problem, it's just trying to get from the building to the playground area and back.
Okay, all right.
Because they're gonna have to have some sort of pathway.
Fair enough, okay.
So, and then, we talked about the nails at the Millennial Park and cleanup.
Yep.
And do we know when that new shed is being built?
What new shed, where?
They asked for a building permit a couple of weeks back, that they were gonna do a new shed at the school.
Oh, the school, okay, you went from park to school, I'm sorry, I wasn't keeping up.
Sorry.
When are they building it? I don't know, I don't have building permit anymore.
Didn't you start?
I don't think we have it anymore.
Didn't you already say?
I thought they were building it in April, isn't that what you said?
I did too, that's what I thought too.
I'm guessing they did not.
And I walked over there last week and it wasn't there, so, is it still not there?
Just make sure it's not in here still.
You do understand it's gonna be this huge cement.
That's what I thought it was gonna be like 35 feet.
40 by 40.
Oh, it rained a lot, right, in April, so.
40 by 40.
Maybe they couldn't do it.
It's all built cement.
That's what I thought it was gonna be, where I was happy that if they were gonna do it in April, we'd have plenty of shade in the summer, but.
Okay, well, I don't have it here still, so they must have picked it up, I don't know when they were supposed to build it, but they have a building permit till the end of the year, so. Anything else for summer rec, or rec in general, sorry?
We have purchase orders for shirts, but that can wait till we get to it.
Okay, all right, the hydro sale lease, we're going to hold off until Ms. Hewer is back, if that's okay with you, because I know she loves talking about that.
Yep.
Historic committee, we haven't met, so I know there's been an email going back and forth, saying if we could meet next week sometime, so. I am gonna add the hoopla to the conversation with them, see if they wanna help with that.
Thank you very much.
You almost missed the meeting.
They had the ongoing work of the raising money for the conversation starting about raising money for the pump house restoration. It used to be down at the mill. Kennybunk closing schedule, Suzanne said this could wait till she got back, or we can act on tonight, if it's a pleasure.
We can wait, because I haven't seen anything this morning.
Yeah, but not in the folder, then we're definitely gonna wait, okay. Policies and procedures.
We'll table it until she gets back, so we can look at it.
Okay, that's the world show on the work table. Chief, ask him to come in, we're at the end of the agenda, you're lucky you showed up when you did.
Good evening.
Good evening, you would have been gone. They move quickly, we're more nimble with it, like two.
Was a little longer than I anticipated.
Okay. Sometime.
The first item, City of Dover purchase order, 1209, two weeks ago, one of our part-time officers was responding to a call, hit the curbing on Third Street, punctured the tire, so we had to replace the tire. So I'm estimating that's gonna be no more than $150 to do that. And that was in Cruiser 73, and then in Cruiser 72, we had to replace the driver's side seatbelt latch, it stopped working. And that is $112.51. Now come out of the vehicle maintenance case.
Move to accept purchase order 1209 to City of Dover for repair of a tire, or a new tire, and replacement of the driver's side seatbelt latch. Chief, you don't have total here, two.
Well, because I estimated the top, the tire.
So up to?
$273.
Okay. Second, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed, all right.
To go along with the new tire.
Yes.
Need a little moment.
Fair enough. All right, what do you want?
So purchase order number 1210 to Sullivan Tire for $89.99 for a alignment.
Move to accept purchase order 1210 to Sullivan Tire for an alignment for $89.99.
Second, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed, all right.
For the last, I don't know, 24 years or so.
You've always wanted to.
We've been either using my truck and/or my utility trailer.
Right.
To put out signs and do the cones and bring the trash and the PD to the dump. And the bike rodeo and picking up large items that we find on the side of the road, grabbing it, sort of case might be. Well, my utility trailer is now no longer roadworthy without some extensive repairs. So I'm recommending to the board that we purchase a utility trailer for the PD from Lowe's. It's a 5x8 all steel utility trailer. And I give you a copy of what it looks like there. For $599, and that will come out of our equipment account. So I do a purchase order number 1211 for Lowe's, and it should be reimbursement to me. I'll purchase it, be reimbursed up in fact. For $599, if you see that.
I can't believe you've had to use your own all this time, Chief.
No, I believe that, I didn't mind.
Thank you. Move to accept purchase order 1211 to Lowe's for one 5x8 utility trailer for $599.
I'll second, so we're going to talk about it. So, I don't know why, I've been in the market for a utility trailer, so I have no idea what the market costs. So I'm going to just ask a stupid question. This is a competitive rate for one of these?
Yes, I checked Lowe's, I checked Tractor Supply store. And they're comparable. If you go to a trailer place, they tend to be few dollars more. It was actually several dollars more.
Yeah.
So.
Okey-dokey. You ready?
Yes.
You good for it? Okay. All those in favor of purchase order number 1211, say aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed? All right. You're your trailer, and thank you for letting the town use it for all those years. So, good news. You've noticed that there's no longer a lift in the front of the town hall.
I see that.
And you know why you were having all that water come in for some of those years?
Can I tell? Can I tell?
Please, I think you would love to hear this.
So, the cupola that you now see down here, that was up there, the last time they roofed it, they stopped the roofing shingles at the cupola. Underneath was just wood, and the big hole was just...
So it's just going into...
Water pouring in from the top, coming down.
Upside down bucket going in.
So that was the water coming down.
Part of the problem.
Across our electrical panel, yes.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, thank you for fixing it.
So maybe we've solved part of the problem.
Part of the problem, yes.
Now, you still don't get to stay down there, but that's part of the problem.
And all this stuff. Yeah, it was just shingles, maybe. Let's hope it was just shingles.
Yeah. Okay, the last item I have, this is a big ticket item. This is, you know, we're talking about an upgrade to our new security system downstairs. And I solicited three requests, one from Pro Technologies, who currently does the alarm system in the building, and Accutel, who currently maintains our existing security system, and then Eastern Alarms. Eastern Alarms came in at over $15,000. Pro Technologies came at $9,658.33, and Accutel came in at $6,023.56. However, they did not include all of the upgrades and whatnot that we originally requested. And speaking with the folks down there, once they add the additional cameras, the monitors, and the additional terabytes, we're looking at probably $10,000. So my recommendation to the board is that we go with Pro Technologies. This way here, I think the long term will be beneficial because we'll have the same company that's taking care of the alarm system as well as the security system. So it all ties into the entire security for the entire building. What's nice about the new upgrade is that if we leave, we can actually take that item with us to the new building, so it's going to have enough memory with it. We're going to keep the existing system downstairs. In the event that we do leave, you will still have something here for this building, and the existing memory that's on there now will be sufficient enough to take care of this floor and the outside whatnot, so.
So is this the $9,000 option?
So I have, yeah, first order number, Mayor Department Technologies, number 1215, it's warrant article number 11, for a 16-channel, 9-terabyte high drive, the cabinet, cables, networking software, 5 cameras, 7 monitors, and 1 video distribution amp for $9,658.33.
Yes, Mayor. $10,000.
$10,000, right?
Yeah.
This is the one that was downgraded.
And we amended it down to $10,000.
Right, yeah, I didn't see replacing the entire system at this point until we knew exactly what police were going to be doing in the future.
Okay, move to accept purchase order 1215 to Pro Technologies for security grade upgrades, warrant article number 11 for a total of $9,658.33.
Second. I just want to make sure we're not having cash. I don't think we're having any cash flow issues, so I think we're okay.
Well, by the time the equipment's ordered and installed, we're looking at probably 2 months anyway.
Okay, I think we're okay, so.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, they called all day. I'm
serious. That'll teach you to come in. I called to see if I needed to come in or not.
Yeah.
We didn't vote on the shit today. All those in favor of purchase order number 1215, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Good, they already signed it. So I wasn't paying attention.
And just for information, we are finalizing the process for the radio upgrade. We're still waiting to hear from the state as far as the repeat is concerned, but I'm quite confident that we're going to be able to clearly stand the 50,000, at least for our radios anyway. So.
Okay.
Great. That's all I have for you. Anything for me?
I don't know what was going on next door to my house the other day, but your two officers did a nice job keeping things quiet and
home.
I don't know what was going on, but tell them they're doing great.
Quite the party on South Street on Thursday night. They're letting off fireworks.
I wonder if anybody called to let us know.
Well, I walked over to see which house it was, and when I saw people standing in the street looking at them, and they're in their backyard, they just stopped. So nobody didn't have to call, but there was a number of people that lived on the street, and those of us from off the street. You can see where all this was coming from, they stopped.
I see for about the last week or so, the truck has disappeared.
It's the same property, so
yeah,
okay. No, you've been there before. So.
But at least the truck is now no longer being parked on the front. We paid him a couple of sits a day. And that was enough. Camper's gone, thank you, but now the truck's going to go as well.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Great.
Did you want to ask your parking question, though? The man that would know more about it than me?
Main Street.
Yeah, there's still parking on Main Street?
Yeah. So we asked them to move on South Street, and then I said, well, what about Main Street? And then, unfortunately, I didn't know the ordinance that it starts kind of here and moves this
way. Well, there's one for not every street
so
is covered under like a blanket.
Main Street,
you've got sections, right? Some parts of streets are covered and some parts aren't, right?
So is Main Street not part of that?
Well, they can't, on Main Street, there aren't any berms or whatnot, and that's state property.
Yeah.
And the state has never complained to us about folks parking there.
Okay.
As long as they don't park on the sidewalk, then it's really not an issue.
Okay.
If the state had put a berm there or, you know, a little barrier, whatever the case might be, then we might be talking about a different story, but. Yeah, now that you asked that question, right. We should really look at that.
The house next door, there's signs out front that say no parking.
We
clearly all the way down to Front Street, you're not supposed to park.
Correct.
But there's nothing.
Right, there's nothing.
That was the question.
Past the first house, there is one up to the first house, after the first house right in this corner. You can't park. Folks couldn't see to the left. But after that, right, there's nothing to prevent them from parking all the way at Main Street.
So. And the only reason why I brought it up is that I didn't want anybody to feel like they're being picked on.
Right. Yeah.
So, like, you you can't park, but you can, and you can, well, why can't they? So I didn't want, so.
Everything for the longest time, right, South Street, for the longest time, we didn't, like, half of it, you couldn't park on the street, right?
Correct.
Or you could, and then the other half you couldn't, so I mean, it was, it's not, it's, sometimes it doesn't seem to be for any reason, but there is, I'm sure, at one time, whenever they came up with these ordinances, but that's why, wasn't it?
Yeah.
There's no uniformity there, right, there's by street.
Right. That orders were designed to protect the town roadways from crumbling at the edges, protect your sidewalks and things like that.
So there is a rhyme or reason, and then we would know, so.
Was it just not?
You're asking the wrong guy, I wasn't here when they put it in, I don't know, so. All I know is Ed did say one night that people wanted to plant trees there in the '70s, and people got very upset, they wanted to lose their parking spaces, and they never brought it up again.
And parking was premium downtown.
So, I don't.
And there's no room for the garage, so.
Definitely not room for the garage, so anyways, do we have, the non-public issue that we had a few weeks ago now, I think, has there been any?
I haven't heard of any.
Okay. Very good. Anything else for the chief?
No.
Have a good night.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, you want your purchase?
Thank you.
Those are yours.
I get the proper one.
Yep. Have a good night.
Thank you.
Board member activity, then the town administration, what do you got going on this week, what do you?
We met last night, we're meeting, rec is meeting again next Sunday night. We're going to be working through the weekend, because school ends on Thursday, and we have.
The game's on?
Monday.
Monday.
So.
When do our t-shirts arrive?
We have to order them.
The check has finally been cashed, so.
So, your purchase order for your t-shirts is right here.
Oh, we can do that, whatever you want, it doesn't matter. Okay, anything else?
A joint loss is coming up, and I think it's next month sometime. And then I'll have to meet with, yeah, joint loss is July 10th at 8 a.m.
Planning board tomorrow night, and historic committee coming up eventually, probably next week sometime, in a workshop, but, I think that's about it. There could be something else coming up, but I don't think so. So, unless we have anything else to talk about there, let's get on to the building permits. We had a lot tonight, it seems like, here.
It's spring.
Spring has sprung, Mr. Clark has reviewed the first one. Oh, we need your stamp, the septic.
I brought it.
Oh, perfect.
It's spring.
Do you mind if I do that while you're stamping them?
Either way.
Actually, no, let's see if there's any others there.
Who's the septic system going?
I'm not sure about that, sorry.
Septic design for 443 Silver Street. I don't have a map and lot, are you okay with that?
Same address.
Okay.
That appears to be the only one, so, first purchase order we have is, building permit, good lord. 2017-055, 184 General John Sullivan Way. What are we doing here? They are replacing three windows, no structural changes. Mr. Clark has reviewed it, and it's gonna be a $95 fee.
Three windows, they hire a building permit?
Well, whatever they're doing, it costs them almost $6,600, so, yeah.
Oh, those are big windows. I'll think twice before I replace my windows.
Yeah, right.
I was thinking.
Better appreciate those windows you've got, because, whatever they're buying, they're expensive, so. The next thing we have is. This is actually an abatement from last year that we've already approved, it says, it's from Andrea, the BOS approved the, Kimball abatement per recommendation of Avatar on 4/17/17, so this year. However, you signed a copy. please sign the attached original and return it to me. So, we've already approved it once, so we'll just sign the, this is the actual, here's our.
Yes, yes, I spoke to her this morning.
Oh, okay, so we will just sign it again then, I guess. Doesn't require any kind of. Next thing is a tax collector's warrant for the property tax levy. In the name of the state, you are hereby directed to collect the property taxes in the list herewith committed to you, amounting to the sum of $3,164,500. And with interest at 12% per annum from July 1, 2017 thereafter on all sums not paid on or before that day. And we further order you to remit all monies collected to the town treasurer or to town treasurer's designee as provided by RSA 41:29, subsection Roman 6, at least on a weekly basis or daily, whenever tax receipts total $1,500 or more. Given under our hands at Rollinsford, New Hampshire, this 23rd day of May, apparently we weren't here, 2017 is for the three of us to sign. So this is the tax levy warrant. Or a levy, rather. I guess I get away with not having to sign the tax levy. Okay, the next one, to the collector of taxes, sir. I guess they didn't get the memo that the majority of women on the board of the select board. Please send in return. Thanks, Andrea. She should know. Sir, by the vote of the select board upon the application of abatement report, we have abated the principal amount of $133,626 on May 31st for properties listed on the attached abatement report for tax year 2017, period 1. Cost of abatement during spring pickup of the value of improvements was not put into assessing, this is what we discussed earlier, by Avatar, and the increase in taxes due to those improvements was not included on the initial 2017 PO1 warrant. Avatar made corrections in assessing to capture the added value of improvements and created supplemental warrants for all properties. It was necessary to abate the amounts noted on the initial warrant represented on the attached abatement report 5/31/17 in order to reissue supplemental invoices for correct billing amounts. Accordingly, the tax collector is instructed to process beginning balance abatements totaling $133,626 for those properties listed on the attached abatement form. And there are a number of them that we have already talked about. So, and some of these are rather substantial. So, there's that for you. That's partially to correct their mistake. Andrew's been busy. All right, please sign on all attached supplements and return. Andrew. What is this? It includes all the supplements report. Tax collector's property tax supplement warrant. Andrea Cass, collector of taxes in said county of Stratford. In the name of the state, you are hereby directed to collect the property taxes committed to you, amounting to the sum of $4,233 and with interest at 12% per annum on all sums not paid 30 days after the bills are mailed. And we further order you to remit all monies collected to the town treasurer or the town treasurer's office provided by RSA 41:29-6, at least on a weekly basis or whenever tax receipts are $1,500 or more. And here we are. Do we have to sign every single one of them? Are you for real? Yep, on all 40 pages. So, there's another reason not to like Avatar.
Do that
non-public? I don't think so. Mm-hmm. So you're not even getting the full signature. They're not even getting the regular scribble. They're just getting like two initials.
So there's 40 pages here?
Yes, ma'am. I'm not going to read all the people's names off. It's a public document. If people want to see it, they're more than welcome. But you're here longer than... I'm trying to sign as fast as I can, Dirty. I'm sorry.
No, I have.
Are you going to have to sign too?
Yes.
We all do.
All three of us are supposed to sign it.
And I have three initials.
Oh, I'm scribbling the name. It's close enough. Some people get a couple of squiggles, some people get three.
It's a time like this when you need the stamp.
Right, if I only had a stamp. An auto pen.
If they only caught 40, I wonder how many more there are.
Are they state companies? Send me something.
I think it's sent you something, but I just wanna make sure they don't get out of order.
Out of order, yes.
You know what, I'm almost done. I don't wanna get out of order.
Nope, that's fine.
That'd be a bad thing.
Nope.
It'll be hard to do order them though. That's perfect. Being at home watching me sign all 40 of these.
They can fast forward through it.
The advantages of watching the meeting happens. Fast forward is more of this.
At this moment in your video, please fast forward 3 minutes.
Right. Unless you wanna watch a full sign 40 pieces of paper.
Twice.
Twice. I didn't wanna call her, so it's my stuff.
Doesn't it make you wonder how many more are still out there?
You're lucky you brought a boogie pipe, because that makes me very angry. Again, I think we really owe a debt of gratitude to our tax collector for doing a stellar job. This is not the first time she has caught mistakes. Not necessarily just from Avatar, but other people.
Didn't we just re-sign with them?
We just signed the contract to do this year's
just the reevaluation.
We're in the contract right now for the reevaluation.
Problem is, we've talked about other options. And then they back us the wrong. But kind of last one. Enjoy. I would suggest scribbling. You okay if I do something else while you're signing?
Please.
All right. To the BOS, Avatar, reviewed the elderly exemption application and determined that this person qualifies. If the BOS concurs, please sign the application and return thank you. So I don't think we need to read the person's name yet. It's private. But. And there's also on the flip side, there's a veterans that. I think this one. A couple here. Please sign the application and return to Andrew. Oh, I'm sorry. It is a. They're two separate addresses. There's one veterans exemption. We're missing the DD-214. The poor person for the elder of the veterans tax credit. You can either get a honorable discharge, a general discharge, or a dishonorable discharge.
Mm-hmm.
Correct. And every DD-214, depending on what era they're from, are slightly different. So this gentleman's generation, when he was in the service, left the service under honorable conditions. The person who was working for the assessing company doesn't understand the nuances of the English language, apparently, and thought under honorable conditions meant less than honorable conditions, and denied this poor veteran his tax credit he's been receiving for, or suggested it, that they didn't qualify when, in fact, the poor man served honorably and was discharged under honorable conditions, so he should still get his exemption. So, talk about Avatar some more. So I'm going to sign this. I'm assuming you're okay with that too, John?
Yes.
Let me just go back to records.
Oh, there's problems everywhere, you know? So, but this one's an easy one to fix. These nice people qualify for these things and they should get them. So, that's an easy one to fix. Let's see, where, oh, maybe it's just a poster note telling us that the veterans one was being taken care of. This is just the lady's information for the elderly's infants.
There is a list of...
It could be further down on my thing.
I think
we
have to.
What?
No, there is, no, just the fact that there's a list of who was exempt and who wasn't, and if they've called today or not.
I fully expect more people to call.
Yes. Well, I was here until 11:30. I'm assuming more calls came in after I left.
Yeah. So, we need to...
You think that would have been done before the tax bills were...
So, I get you to fix that. We'll have to just do a supplemental for that. Okay, so this is an easy one. I'm just doing them in order, I'm sorry. I'll move purchase order number 1297 to Staples for, that'll make you happy, for one black cartridge for the fax machine for the town clerk, I think, for $52.99.
Seconded.
All right, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, okay.
Was that $159? What was that one?
The amount is $52.99.
$52.
And it's to Staples, and
yeah.
It's purchase order $12.97, so you don't
yeah,
need it,
I
guess. I'll just leave it in my folder. All right, next we have building permit. This is a biggie, too. 2017-053, 34 Wentworth Street. They actually have a number, but just so we know, it's... map to, it's 218-7, so map and lot number, which I think with these new properties, it's good to give both, but Mr. Clark has reviewed it. It's a new construction, and the fee will be $2,405. Be quiet, that one. They just included another copy, didn't they? Perfect. Okay. Sign that, please. And it looks like the last one is... it's building permit number 2017-056. It's 40 Jesse Doe Road. It's the cellular tower. It's Verizon Wireless is adding, they're replacing their existing Verizon antennas and supporting equipment on the existing pole. To the tune of $60,000 worth of value of construction. So the fee is $625. They need to send us a check for an additional $25. Send us a check for $600. So, but that's... Which Mr. Clark has reviewed it too. And I think, did I miss something? At the end of my file, I think we've got enough, don't you? Have you started signing yet?
No, I will not.
Oh, okay. That's really good. Pull up the folder while you get assigned. Are we good?
Yep.
Where is your folder?
Oh, sorry to talk about Founder Street. Already signed the right ways.
Perfect.
We already talked about our bond on SCD. Paving at 79 Rollins Road.
Did I sign that one already, didn't I?
Oh, yeah, she did.
Okay.
Sign that one.
That one I need one.
And there's another paving one in here too, so I just want to get that.
Are those other letters I got to sign?
Yes. 37 Rollins Road paving.
She's coming back here. All right. Maura Cario. 37 Rollins Road, dear Ms. Cario. I'm sure I just put her name as well. The select board has been apprised of the following activity at 37 Rollins Road paving, and that it's the same exact language I read earlier. You know.
Mm-hmm.
You think we'll be signing it?
So moved.
All right.
Okay.
Isn't there a building permit?
Mm-hmm. You can file them.
I know, and that's...
Mm-hmm.
They did, we got one...
I'd want to look at that one.
I asked her to double check. Which one are you talking about?
37.
Yeah, I asked her to check that this morning.
Oh, and it wasn't.
We did get one, I think in the 70s though, or something.
Yeah.
I know we just did one for 79, but we did get one,
I think it was
77.
Yeah.
All right. A lot of activity in
Rome. So,
mm-hmm.
43 Kelvin for roofing. And there's two copies. One was in her signature, one is in your signature. So
okay, Gary and Deanna Poplowski, sorry. 43 Kelvin Drive. Yeah, let me say it again. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Poplowski, the select board has been apprised of the following activity of 43 Kelvin Drive. Roofing, and it's the same exact boilerplate language. Please call the town hall. Would you be signing it?
So moved.
All right.
Main Street roofing as well.
Uh, 503 Main Street, dear Mrs. and Mrs. Love, select board has been apprised of the following activity at 503 Main Street roofing. Good with me signing it? Well, this is kept.
So moved. Several. So, do you want individual motions or one motion?
Whatever you want to do. We can do it. You can put them all together.
Okay.
Just list their names.
So. Oh. I don't have a list. Oh, I do. Okay.
We need to know their names before we can.
Yes. I thought there was only first names. Okay. So I'll give these over to you to get the spelling right. So I make a motion to hire Isabella Salvati for summer rec at $8.25 an hour. Sam Mitchell for summer rec for $7.50 an hour. Jada Laughlin for summer rec at $7.50 an hour. Janessa Pellman for $8.25 an hour. And Andrew Gray, our director, for $13 an hour.
Been moved and I'll second it. All those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
No one's opposed. So congratulations to Mr. Gray. Do I have to? I have to sign in the right place, is what I have to do. And to Ms. Hellman?
Oh, sure.
And Ms. Laffin, Laffin? Mr. Mitchell? And Ms. Salvati. Anything else?
Of course.
What's that? You say of course?
Of course.
Is there, oh, is that Hellman or something?
I'd like to see that. That was just Suzanne's.
Yeah.
It's in the office. Can I move along, or do you wanna go now? No, that's okay, I didn't.
That's all right.
You wanna do those later?
Well, let me just get them.
Okay.
I'll just.
All right, this requires your signature, this is our fuel bid for the state.
Yeah.
Our annual.
For the vehicles?
Yes.
Our application, so we can buy if we want. Fuel, what is that? Better fuel tax, good. Good one you are.
Are you good?
Mm-hmm.
Move to accept purchase order 838 to Martha Kuchar for $114 for Doe burial ground cleanup on May 16th. Pick up branches, rake cemetery area, brush cut outside of cemetery area.
All those in favor? Or do you wanna discuss it, sorry?
Don't you have a, didn't you bring this up last year?
Yeah, well, I don't serve on the board, so.
Okay, so moved.
I have said what I've said, and that's all that has been done, I guess, so.
Okay.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed, all right.
Move to accept purchase order 839 to Green Shadow Property Maintenance, cemetery mowing, one Newtown and Old Town Cemetery. This is the second mowing of the year for $1,345.
It's been moved and seconded. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 So this is our health officer and or deputy appointment form. So if Sean decides to stay on as health officer, this is the form that we have to fill out, or if we find someone new, if he chooses not to. Yeah, so it's on.
You wanna put a post-it note on that, just saying that we would like to reappoint, oh no, that was the ADA coordinator, sorry. So we've already said we wanna reach out to Mr. Glidden.
Yes, Caroline said she has reached out to him.
Okay. At the very least, if we lapse, we have a deputy, Tom Clark is the deputy, so.
Yes, I asked him this morning if he wanted to be health officer in case Sean didn't,
and he was not really fond of the idea, but he doesn't mind being deputy.
Yeah, as I said, do they have to be a resident to be the actual health officer? And I think the deputy can be an out-of-town or anything.
Oh, good question.
I think that's what we ran into. I think that's what we found out last year. That's why he could actually be the deputy. But I don't think he can if he wanted to, so.
Okay.
Mrs. Allen, I'll have $500.
Yes, $510.
Oh, is it gone up? Oh, good for them. Good for them.
That 2% raise.
Good for them.
So, this is our maintenance agreement for the lift, at, on the side of the building. Our yearly maintenance agreement. Can I find it in a month?
Being executed in August, that's a good thing.
Yes.
So my problems, like my past?
Maybe your eyes will find it faster. I see the contract, but I don't see a quote.
$660.
Thank you.
Right, so you moved that? All right, moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, 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 okay. What else we got there?
Okay, purchase, move to accept purchase order 1213 to Seacoast Printing for printing of the Camp Raleigh shirts, the blue ones for the campers and counselors and the gray ones for the community, for a total of $1,508.
All right, I'll second that. How much did you all raise, those of us buying t-shirts, you know? Is that enough to offset the...
Yes, they made a profit on the shirts.
Good, that's awesome. Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed? All right. Still keep looking down.
I keep looking.
See what day it is.
My disbursement form for second quarter.
All right, you want to get paid? Let's do it.
Let me see that.
The...
I just want to check.
I just want to sign. Okay.
Yeah, okay, got it.
I broke the trend. I did not look at my watch. Right, what is it?
Thank you.
Thank you for your service.
10 cents an hour. Oh, this is the background check for a new resident. For our new...
Checking our residents as they move in now, are we?
For our new
officer.
Part-time, no, our part-time
oh, the
agent
attendant?
Jeff.
Perfect. You good to go?
Yes.
All right, are you signing anything?
I don't think so. I'm going to check. File on record. Nope, it's like just an FYI.
He said it worse than mine. I'll make it close. Perfect. All right. Great.
All right. The hydroelectric facility sent us our check.
Oh, good.
For first quarter.
How bad is it?
$12,891.17.
Better than, well, no, because... quarterly, right?
Yeah.
It's usually
first
about 36, so, yeah, I know, not excited. It's about right.
48.
Yeah.
48.
What did we budget for?
Yeah, under 50 for sure. So.
35.
I'm sorry, perfect.
Okay.
No, I don't think
so. All right, school administration, FYI for the estimated payment schedule from July to June of next year.
Mm-hmm.
Will be about $414,000. Let me try that again.
$400,000?
Thank you.
Wait, here it is.
Per month.
Big meeting.
Just an FYI.
Not too much on the agenda.
Almost done. We're close.
Record time.
No.
Bridge aid preliminary estimate. Caroline will tell me about this morning. We qualify for the 80-20, but not eligible till 2024.
I was gonna say, maybe we missed a boat then. You mean for Old Mill Lane?
Yes.
Okay, so we're on the list, we're good.
Yep.
And 2024 will be eligible for funding?
Yep.
It'd be 80-20 match then?
Yes.
All right, maybe we put a post-it note on that and give to Suzanne.
Right.
If she's gonna wanna,
And then the printing machines we're holding off.
Okay.
And that is the bottom of my pile.
All right, so, I don't have anything else. Is there, we reviewed all the correspondence, any other community input for the evening?
The question you asked earlier is, we brought in at this point, $400 in community sales, for the rec shirts. However, there's roughly $80 on order, so it'll be up higher than that. The people have ordered them, but they have not yet paid, so.
Okay, so, but the costs are gonna be covered?
Yes, fortunately, we had a sponsor come in and give us a large portion, which will cover all of the camper shirts and the counselor shirts, and that offset us ordering a couple extras.
Okay, awesome. Any other community input? Alrighty then, we still need to do the, do a non-public for personnel, so you wanna make a motion?
Motion to go on a non-public for reasons that I'm not,
I'll second that, and we'll do a roll call. Jody?
Aye.
Mike, yes, we are a non-public.